Anamaka Ajuju Kamnaju.
You have to pull yourself together, son. Personally, I do not know how I am going to forget this tragic loss in a hurry. But all the same, the gods knows why they took her. You cannot fight the gods.
I thought she has escaped it. I thought she has cheated on death.
I thought the same, son. I do not know why the gods have chosen to take her this time. But they are not going to be blamed. Ezemor has a lot to explain to this.
It's not his fault, father. He has no right to change the will of the gods. Just that these things was never shown to him. He led us on a blind faith.
And that is exactly the reason I will never forgive him in a hurry. Never.
Nah. All of my cast go. I need to leave this village immediately.
Okay, so where do you intend going from here?
I'm here to decide, but I just need to leave this town immediately.
You're sounding serious. What's up? What happened?
I killed Obiora in the presence of my girl, Uju.
You did what? Why go lose God? How would you do such a thing?
He wanted to kill her. He almost strangled her to death if I didn't show up. So I have to do what I had to do to protect my girl.
Now, wow. This is serious, oh. See now.
That's the reason why I need to leave this town immediately.
But your woman ought to understand it was in her defense you acted now. She's supposed to know now.
She will not go understand.
Why? Women.
She will not understand. See, bro, I beg. You see. Bro, miss more money. Make I add to the one where I get. So I feel leave this village immediately before the police come.
Yeah. That one has small matter. That one has small thing. You could just wait there. My said the phone and generator were at TV yesterday. If I just tell him two, just give me 2 days, my healer.
Bro, I don't get 2 days. You don't understand what I need to tell you. I don't have 2 days. If I did leave here now, I need to the chapel immediately for this town. I beg.
What do you want me to do now? But in a depend spirit, I don't know why they dropped it. 2 days. If I said that generator now, I know I could raise like 10k to reach you, go anywhere they go.
I was about coming to look for you. Yeah? I'm sure you must have heard. I am very sure right now that this devil daughter of yours, this cursed Obanje, is happy that her prophecy has come to pass, okay? Your prediction has come to pass. You're happy.
Why will I be happy? I don't even wish such predicament on anybody. Not to talk more of Obiora. I am pained, Mama.
Clap for yourself. prophetess of doom. Clap for yourself. Demon from the pit of hell, clap for yourself. He's dead now. No, your position has come to pass. You should clap. I tell you something. As I'm in pain like this, you will never know peace for the rest of your life.
I reject it.
For the rest of your life?
Hey, no more.
As I mourn the death of my loved one, you will never ever witness happiness. No, happiness ceases from your life this minute. And you will die single for the rest of your life.
God forbid. It's not my portion.
You will remain single.
Why are you saying this?
Mama, as I have said it, so shall it be.
But she didn't kill Abiora. She didn't kill Abiora now. Eh? The idiot that killed him is in the police custody now. It's not your sister's fault now. Why are you cursing her?
Owagi.
Owagi. If you want one more. If he, hi. If he want more,
hi. Ezemo. From the look of things, the king is not happy with you. So I will advise you, do not go close to him now, and he is done grieving.
Oh no. Why would the king be angry? It is not my fault. All I told him was what was shown to me by the gods of our land.
The gods of our land? Since when did the gods start lying?
Caution, Ono. We speak of the gods here.
Foreigners don't know who should take the caution. Is it me or you who has used the name of the gods in vain? I can't understand you.
Ono, I will not stand here and watch you insult me. Yes.
Zemo, me insulting you? You should know that you should be thanking the Igwe for not disturbing you of what you did. You failed. That little girl, yes, she's gifted in divining the future, not you.
Oh no, can we in Kebezu? Upon him, Mr. Honry, now one way go wherever. Nga Wanyele, and the Mwanyele. If I get
me. Me? What can you do? The gods has abandoned you. Hard up, you got your business, you get me. Hey! Again.
Oh God of my ancestors, why have you deserted me? What a humiliation. Huh? Haven't I served you for years? Huh? Where did I go wrong? You let an egg break a pancake, leaving the stone ashamed. Huh? I will stop serving you. You do not answer my prayers anymore. No, I give up! I give up! No more!
If you touch me,
what are you doing?
What does it look like I'm doing? Burning them to ashes.
Are these all my clothes?
The clothes that I dashed you, right? No, Ichefugo. Do you have memory loss? The clothes that I dashed you. And right now, I want you to go inside. Pack everything you know that I've given to you that are currently in your possession. Bring them out now. I would rather wash them, burn to ashes, than have you wear them. You are evil, this girl.
Stop it!
Now?
Stop, please. I'm sorry. If you burn all these clothes now, which clothes will I now be wearing?
I want you to go naked. I want you to go naked. You have to dance naked in the market square so people will see your nakedness. I know that you are evil. You are wicked. Wicked.
I'm sorry.
Sorry, kill you there.
I didn't kill him.
You didn't kill him?
I didn't kill him.
Do you know that I would have rather preferred you are the one that died than my Obiora? You are not supposed to, for any reason whatsoever, to be living, sharing this same living world with the living. You are not supposed to be here. You're supposed to be dead and gone. You are evil. You are evil.
I'm evil.
I'm sorry.
I don't kill him. You know death is inevitable now. Because
what you did to your sister is pure wickedness. That is wickedness now. How could you do that to your sister?
What she did to me is wickedly wicked.
What did she do to you? Came for Maggie. That she saw something about your man and told you about it. Had it been you listened to your sister, you would have ended this relationship and averted this danger.
Mama, she did not carry her big poisonous viper mouth to go and be putting on waiting to consign her. Business that is not her problem. Obiora wouldn't have tried killing her.
Did you hear yourself speak? Obiora was about killing your sister. If not, that Ebuka jumped into the scene and saved your sister. Why would Obiora want to kill her? Came on, Jebuya. Came for me. What did she do?
Mama, I can never fault Obiora. The whole fault is on your daughter. The flippant mother that cannot keep her mouth one place. Always seeing evil, evil, evil for people.
It's not her fault that she's a seer.
Okay.
Kill your problem.
Mama, let her try and see for you now, or see for herself. But she don't want change in her life.
But you're being wicked, though. Look at yourself and see the kind of wickedness you're melting on your sister.
Okay.
I like being, I stand on the path of justice. Better stop this before you get out of hand, though.
Mama, do me, I do you. Man, no go verse. Yeah. Go. This is just the beginning, though. This is just the beginning.
Better end this.
It's not
end this. This is wickedness, though. End this scene, though.
We are just in part one. Yeah, okay. Mama, can't be the beginning, sir. This is the beginning, oh. This is the beginning, oh. How about this thing in there? But this is the beginning. Beginning.
You see this, your sister. She knows what she's doing. She knows.
I don't understand.
You don't understand. If she swear that she didn't have a solution to what was to before Obiora, I am very sure that Ogoku will kill her. Very, very sure.
Wait a minute. You mean she has a solution?
Yes, of course. Who sees a vision that doesn't have a solution to it? Eh? Why are you believing her? She's not innocent after all. Because if she's innocent, she will know. She's not innocent. Let your sister know what she's doing. She knows. And I'm even thinking you're not believing her. The way you're behaving, you are.
No matter how you hate, do not hate an innocent.
Hi, Uju. Tragedy has happened. Aluchi's body was found decomposing in a shallow grave.
What?
Oh my God, that's God. But I warned her. I cautioned her.
I don't understand. You met her?
I saw the spirit of death hovering around her. I brought it to her notice. I cautioned her. Who could have done such an evil act?
Don't empathize over her death. Come on, she was already planning to get rid of you. I think she got what she deserved.
What? Don't say that. No matter what, she's still our friend. I mean, she was a good friend. Oh, God.
Greetings, my prince.
Greetings.
My prince, please, I am sorry for what happened to your mother. I wish there was something I could have done to avert it. Please do not punish me. I beg of you, my prince, please.
I did not bring you here so that I can punish you. I know what happened to my mother is quite unfortunate and heartbreaking, but that's not the reason you're here. You know, I'm still amazed by your power of clairvoyance. I want us to be friends. I want you close to me so you can be directing my footsteps.
My prince, I don't direct people's footsteps. All I do is see visions for people, especially the unfortunate ones. That's all.
I understand, but I still insist you are the right person to direct my footsteps henceforth. And I will make you my special advisor. How does that sound?
Do you know that? Anybody in this land that hurts you equally hurts me. That girl is too small to be a threat to you. Just allow me to kill this girl. I can kill her before sundown. No. Papa, I said no. Let her be. I will find a better way to do it. Why you think about this thing I'm telling you? Let me just kill her once and for all. Do you know the level of disgrace this girl has brought upon you? Do you know?
I said no, AGK. Enough of this conversation. Are you not going hunting today?
Papa, I will go.
But think of it. Let me kill her.
What do you mean by you saw the guards taking her to the palace?
Mama, I was with her and the next thing the guard came and took her away.
Hey! Shimala Potapam. They took her to the palace. Hi! They want to kill this girl. They want to kill this girl. Ah, Mama, me. I'm going to the palace. Let me down. Ujuma, Mama. Why did they take you to the palace?
The prince said he wanted to see me.
Hi! Oh. So now he's blaming you for the death of the queen. Ah!
No, Mama.
I know. I must take care of this village. You can't kill no, Mama.
It's not because of it. He just wants to be friends with him.
What? It's it.
My baby.
You want to be what?
Nna Amaka. Is anybody home? Oh, your mother. Is your mother and the sister around? Are you not the one I'm talking to? Could you imagine? She just abandoned me. What are these children of these days? What kind of children do we have these days?
Nai, good morning.
Nna Amaka.
Good morning.
Good morning. Is anything wrong with your daughter, the one that just left? I was talking to her and she just abandoned me like nobody.
You were like, if you want.
Yes.
She has not been in a very good mood for a long time. But Leo, she met with him. I hope there's no problem. This one that you came here.
No problem. I've just come to see your daughter this year. Is she around?
She's not around. Is the royal family that asked you to come and bring her? Are they accusing her of killing the queen? It's not, she didn't kill the queen, no. Oh, when he was that is just a prophecy call for one.
Nna Amaka.
Eh?
I know. Nobody's accusing her.
Oh, you know?
Of course, everybody. Do you? Hey. I have just come to see her on my own. I just need her help. Is she around? Please, call her for me.
On your own?
Of course, yes.
I need you. I can't wait to strangle that idiot with my bare hands.
Strangle who? Who are you referring to?
Why are you sounding like you don't know who I'm talking about? I'm talking about the so-called seer.
My brother, come out from there. You see? My worst saucy. Just come out from there. Say something else, please. Alpha,
why are you acting like you didn't see the humiliation of my father? To the extent that the villagers no longer respect my father. My father almost destroyed his shrine because of that so-called girl. And you act like you don't know what I'm talking about.
My friend, I will say this to you. You have to listen because I will say it just once. Because you are my friend, though. Whatever that have to do with the seer, Oga Bawoso, Onwenwe Logwo, death has no medicine. Are you hearing me? But what's up? What is that you saying? I thought you even called me here for something important. Maybe if I get ready, you're just saying something, saying rubbish. Have you seen?
I thought you're a hard guy. A hard guy that I used to know. And if I knew you were a coward. You sounded like a coward.
But you know the pain spirit now. Who's talking about being a coward here? You supposed to know me. But when it comes to the seer or God, no one has ever threatened her life and come out free or survive it. So I have just one advice for you. Have a rethink, or better still, count me out. Count me what? Out. Oh, when we logo now.
Amechi, I will be the first to kill her and I will still be alive.
My king, I am sorry for what happened to the queen. I wish you don't punish me for it. And sincerely,
don't worry, my daughter. You don't have to blame yourself.
Actually, I ask you to come here to apologize to you for not believing in what you said about my late wife. If I had believed in what you said, her last days on earth would have been very, very memorable.
I wish there was something I could have done to avert that vision. But I was just helpless. I couldn't do anything.
Like I said originally, you don't have to blame yourself at all. You can't avert what the God already have designed. Just don't blame yourself. All right?
You're right, Your Majesty. Thank you so much for your understanding.
Thank you. Just like my son said earlier, I would like you to be part of this royal family. I would like you to be our eyes in the spiritual realm and watch our back. My daughter, you're welcome.
Your Highness, I promise to always be at your service.
Good. My dear, what my father here is trying to say is that you can even come and live here with us. We need you to inform us and direct us in any way that you can.
You're welcome.
Why are you like this? I know getting over Obiora will be very difficult for you right now. But you have to move on, my dear. He's dead and gone.
Everybody keeps saying, move on, move on, move on. Move on to where? No, move on to where? When the person that killed my man is still alive and living. Not just living, living under the same roof with me. And you expect me to move on like it's so easy, right?
Are you referring to your sister? But you know it's that hooligan Ebuka that killed her, right?
Onye, listen to me.
Yes.
Ebiora, my fiancé, wouldn't have been dead by now if my useless sister and her evil prophecy were not in the picture. I mean, if she had kept her mouth closed and don't go about saying things for people that did not ask for it, my man would still be living for me till now. He will still be alive, I am sure. But remember I said this. I will make her feel worse pain than I am feeling. Now I must get my pound of flesh. I will make her life so miserable that she will beg for death. She won't see it. If mark this word.
If it's okay. You just have to stop crying, okay? Please.
Why do you want to go to the palace?
Well, Mama, the king asked me to come and stay at the palace with him.
The king asked you to come and live in the palace?
Yes.
But why would you leave me and your sister here to go and live in the palace?
Well, Mama, I just told him I'm going to think about it.
Ha. Why would the king ask you to come and live in the palace with them?
Mama.
How come what are they now?
He just wants me to be guiding and informing him on some certain things. That's all. But I've not made up my mind yet.
Better. Can't he be calling you from here? You come and answer him. Well, Onowu was here earlier on to see you.
Oh, yes, I've seen him.
Eh?
One of his daughters will be getting married very soon. It's actually good news.
Hey! Good news! His daughter getting married. Hey, Ujumwa, equal one good news. Good news! Hey! Onowu will be so happy.
He will. I mean, he is very happy.
He'll be so happy. see you. Mama. Ella will be so happy.
Yes.
Ay, 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 ay.
My prince, father, consider getting married to her.
Who?
The Seer girl.
Dad?
Don't get me wrong. We need that girl more than we need as a mourner. And getting married to her will bring her closer to us.
I don't think so, Dad. I mean, proposing marriage to her now may suggest desperation from our side. And besides, I'm not ready to marry yet.
I do not want us to miss this opportunity.
I understand, Father. But we need to be patient with this girl to make her decision.
Ifeanyi, I want to know what it is that your sister did that you have hardened your mind, your heart, never to forgive her. What is it that is so hard for you to forgive your sister? Eh?
Mama, please, in the name of God, I don't want to talk about Ujumwa here. Ejima Fachukwayogi, please. Please.
No, but keep. But why is your heart so strong? She's your blood, though. Of one name, the only sister you have in this world. Ikokwane now, let this go.
Mama, what are you looking from my mouth? No, what is it you want to hear from me? Mama, please, whatever you are looking for, I tell you, you will not get it. Simple and short, I don't want to talk about Uju. Is he a problem?
I know why I'm saying this. You're pushing Uju to relocate to the palace. Yeah, that's what you're doing. If you don't forgive her, she'll just relocate to the palace.
Huh?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Wait a minute. Uju wants to relocate to the palace. As in, she wants to move to the palace.
Yes. The king asked her to move to the palace with him. And the reason she will consider this option is because she doesn't have peace in this house. You don't want to give her peace. You don't want to forgive her. Every day, this constant quarreling. I know that is what will push her to make her decision to move in there. To have her peace now. Why? Why are you doing this now?
Hey. Mama, wait. As in, Ujuma wants to move to the palace.
She has not decided, but the way I'm seeing things, she might make up her mind to move. Oh, I have already called her. Why are you here? Every day, constant worry. What is it now? Ha! She will go to the palace.
Greetings, my king. Your guards refused me entrance through the gate. When has he gotten to this?
Ezemo, what are you doing here?
My king, I came to see you. I came to see you, my king. For how long will you continue to be shutting me out, your king? I came to see you.
I heard that part of your shrine was destroyed.
Yes, my king. I was angry and frustrated.
Ezemo, you know you brought this to yourself. I told you that girl was genuinely gifted by the gods. But you didn't listen to me. Rather, you were unnecessarily jealous of her. You even lied to me on what the gods said that they did not say about my little wife. You lied to the king of this kingdom.
My king, I swear, it came from the guards.
Will you shut that thing you call mouth before I shut it? I decided to forgive you for obvious reasons. If not, by now you would have been stripped of this position and given to another because you failed me. You failed the kingdom. Listen and listen, Ray God. Go and make peace with that girl. I want you to work in tandem with her. that girl is indeed from the gods. And all her due respect must be accorded to her. You may leave my presence.
Leave!
The god said when the god did not say anything.
Ajuju kam naju.
There is no way I will allow her to do this to me. She cannot just move to the palace and live happily ever after with the prince while I'm left languishing in sorrow here. Never. Look at me. I'm not getting any younger and yet nothing to show for it. She will never experience joy. Never!
I am considering allowing my daughter to go and live in the palace.
To the palace?
Uh-huh.
That means you will not see her again unless you visit the palace.
It's for her own safety, Makandria. For her life.
Mm-hmm. Does this have to do with Ezemo's threat?
No, not Ezemo's threat. It has to do with her sister. Ever since she lost her suitor, she has been so angry. She's blaming the sister for everything. And with the level of anger I see in her, I'm afraid she might do something bad to the sister. So it's better she goes to the palace where she's safe. For now, all the kwamu to her.
You can never predict their next action.
One name.
Anyway, just keep on talking to her. To go easy on her anger. Truth is that what happened to the boy was quite unfortunate.
Thank you, my sister.
What? Whose fault is this?
Ifugia. Is she not a seer?
Hey.
I don't know why she's taking it personal on the sister.
You
don't know what I'm going through in that house.
It's not easy. Just keep on talking to her. I believe with time she will calm down.
I will.
You see, okay?
Thank you, Nemo.
Oh, sir.
Thank you. Mwanadalo, sir.
Recording.
We'll meet later.
Okay, thank you. Dalo, sir.
We are on our way to your house to see you.
Yes. I am not in the mood to divine anyone's future for now. Please help us. Today is exactly 7 years of marriage and we have nothing to show for it. I said I am not in the...
Please. 7 years is too much for someone to stay in marriage without any results. Please help them, Bikuno.
Comfort. You will give birth to a bouncing baby boy before the year runs out.
Hey!
Congrats.
Baby, thank you. May the gods be praised.
Yes. Hey, thank you very much. Thank you.
But you? You will betray your wife even before the baby comes.
This woman, I can never do anything like that.
I have spoken.
Did you hear that? Did you just hear that?
But I can never do that.
There's nothing she has ever said that has never come to pass. Nothing. Everything she has said has come to pass. So I don't believe you. I don't.
Guinea Obi.
Onyi. Onyi.
Ify.
I really want to hurt my sister. God knows I really want to hurt her very bad that she'll never forget in a hurry. But whenever I remember she's my sister, it weakens me and I hate that for me.
Can you hear yourself? She's my sister. She's my sister. And yet she hurts you in the way I can never hurt my blood. She's not your sister.
I want to hurt her. Can you imagine this wicked girl wants to move to the palace so that she can be enjoying herself? Why I continue to grieve? I want to hurt her back. I want to do her strong pain. Something she will never forget in a hurry.
Don't worry. There are so many ways to do that.
Will you please, how?
Leave that to me. Don't you trust your friend? Leave that to me.
I can't wait.
No matter how you hate, do not hate an innocent.
Don't you? Amara, please just let me be. I'm not in the mood.
Don't you, what is this? Huh? Who got you upset?
Didn't you see what happened there? I told you I was not in the mood to divine anybody's future, but you wouldn't listen to me. Nothing good would ever come out of it. Nothing.
What are you saying? Huh? You just brought joy into the life of a couple that has been looking for a child for years.
And ended up giving them bad news afterwards. What does that even make me? A mean person? Come on. I'm no longer proud of myself. I can't keep hurting people.
It's not your fault. Such is life. You told the man what he needs to know and he's left for him if he wants it to come to pass.
You don't understand it, Tamara. This man is going to marry another wife, and I cannot even do anything about it. I can't even change it.
Uchu, I understand. See, don't let that affect your decision. Think about the joy you've brought into their life, the hope you've rekindled. Please. Please now, my friend. Okay? You can't change everything. It's okay.
Oh, can see, Jay. This girl has dealt with me. And if I kill her now, it will arouse suspicion from the king. Just look at my shrine. Everybody has deserted it. No single sacrificial items from the villagers for days now. Is this how life is? It's better I leave this village. I can't deal with this humiliation at all. It's better I leave.
Where's your sister?
And who was?
Come and sit down here. Ujuma!
Mama, what is it?
Mama, as both of you should sit down here.
So and who was one?
Because we have to eat this food together. Mama, do not be also so.
Me, Mama, eat this food. Mama, I'm very hungry because.
See, if you consider me your mother, if you see and believe that I'm your mother, now sit down here and do exactly what I said.
Mama, please, first of all, I don't eat with vultures and evil plotters. Dish I own for her separately. She must not eat with
us. That will not have to happen in this house. All of us will eat in the same place together. Nora, do you ever say so?
You don't force my mouth.
If I'm your mother, sit down here. Don't you want to tell me I'm not your mother?
Mama, stop blackmailing me. I'm sitting down because of you, but stop black. Don't blackmail me.
Sit down. Thank you. Ngwa, to worry about. If you want, Ngwa, put your hand here. If I were put your hand here.
Mama, to be honest with you, I'm not really hungry.
Hey, put your hand, we must eat together.
Mama, this food will not even be enough for me. Go find that food and would you not touch it? They finally ate it.
Mama, I don't want to eat this good.
The devil that wants to scatter this family will not see the brightness of tomorrow. I must scatter it. The unity in this family must be. Mbamu is very also.
Abby, please. I swear I will never cheat on you.
How will I leave you and go and marry to another woman? Eh? Or impossible? I can never do that, Nembikono.
How can I believe you when nothing that girl has ever said didn't come to pass? Everything she has ever said came to pass.
I swear, this one can never come to pass. I can never cheat you. Never.
I don't believe you. I don't believe you at all.
Please, I can never betray you, my love. Believe on me. How will I leave a woman that will give me a male child and go and start searching for that woman? Or the possible na meme.
See, Okoli, Biko, just wrap up, Mark. Please leave me alone. I don't believe all these things you're saying. Happen.
Abby. Abby.
No matter how you hate, do not hate an innocent. No matter how you feel.
I would like to have a talk with you.
No, a talk with you. Me. They sent you again. No, can I hesitate again this time around? No, talk with who? Can't you stay on your own? Is it too difficult for you to do? So you will come and tell me another demonic vision of
why? Why are you sounding like
no,
this?
No, spoiler alert!
I thought you were done with this so much animosity.
You know, he's done with animosity. Eh? We are not done with anything because I don't know who you are anymore. Just mind your business. Why am I mind my business? Meaning that you should be staying on your own. As far as I am concerned in this world, you, Juma, is my number one enemy. Know you today.
I see evil in your eyes. But trust me, whatever plan you have for me will backfire.
Tashabapo, you're not gonna know what you are talking about. I'm gonna go and fight what is fighting you and leave me alone. You and who is talking about evil?
Like I said, be minding your business while I mind my business. Because in peace. Don't be coming to me. Mind your business. Only you know what you are saying. Only you know who is pursuing you and the evil you are seeing. Idiot.
No matter how you hate, do not hate an innocent. No matter how you feel, do not hurt an innocent. Makana.
Grace.
It hasn't been long ago. What are you doing here?
I came for a burial with my uncle. So I decided to get things for my kids.
Akosekwana. You are married, right?
Not really. It's a long story. I can't believe this is here after 7 years.
It's me, sound and healthy.
Wow.
Is that good?
There is something you should know.
Like, anyway, the weather is not favorable. Let's go to the bar and then sort it out.
Nice.
Hey.
We made a request the last time you visited, and up to this moment, we've not had anything from you.
Your Majesty, I had a lot that I needed to sort out. But I'm fine now.
So, what do you say about coming to live with us here in the palace?
I have accepted.
Oh my God, that's good news, Father. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
I and the palace appreciate this.
Thank you.
My daughter, that is just a wise decision that we just taken. I promise. I'll make this royal palace very, very comfortable for you, as far as I'm alive.
Thank you, Your Majesty. And I promise to be of good behavior and always do my best when it comes to visions for the palace.
I trust you.
Some says she's evil, others says she's a gift, but what do you think?
What is it now? Why are you blocking me? Leave my way now. What is it?
And if I don't leave your way, what would you do? Call your girls to strike me.
What do you want?
I saw the way you humiliated my father. You made people not to believe him. Father used to be the mediator of the gods to the people. But you stopped that.
Well, I did nothing to your father.
You shut up!
I only told the people the truth.
What truth? What truth? Eh? Listen, I would have used this cutlass to cut your head off. But I promised my dad I wasn't going to hurt you. But I have an advice for you. Leave this village before weekend. You have 3 days. 3 good days to do it.
If I were you, I would just keep quiet and listen to the vision that I have for you.
I am talking about you leaving, and you're talking about vision. Are you mad? Are you mad? Leave now. Leave. Leave.
No matter how you hate, do not hate an innocent. No matter how you feel.
Hey, I'm surprised to see you.
Even me. After you left Ikotegwene for a church program, which was the last time I saw you.
Yes.
I took in.
You took in? I don't understand.
I discovered that I was pregnant.
What?
I told my uncle about it, and we hope we are going to return from the program. But you never did. I tried several times to terminate that pregnancy. But my uncle refused. He insisted I keep the pregnancy. I later delivered of a set of male twins.
But what are you saying?
They are 7 years of age each.
Huh?
Yes, and they are currently living with me and my uncle, waiting for the day I will lay my eyes on their father.
Hey! Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. For 7 years now, me and my wife, we are searching for a male child.
You are the father of my twin boys.
Where would I see your uncle? Let me go and greet him.
So you're happy about it?
Very well. One man,
you're happy.
Very well. Very well.
Mama, I have made up my mind to go to the palace. I'll be moving my things first thing tomorrow morning.
What? You're joking, right?
Mama, I'm not joking.
But I thought you said you have not made up your mind. And now I've called for a meeting to make peace between you and your sister. I thought by doing this, you stay at home.
Mama, I've already made up my mind. Please. There is this evil that is looming around, and I'm trying to prevent it. So I'd rather leave this place to the palace.
Are you not going to say anything about it?
Osimife Yuma. What? Why are you calling me now? No, you are calling me to do what or to say what? She has already made up her mind to leave for the palace. So what is my business? I'm not like I even want her to stay safe. So let her be going. And I'm
gone. Is that all you have to say?
Mama, you are looking for my mouth this afternoon, Okoya. No, you are looking for my mouth now.
Before, no, but don't you say anything?
You did not see me. Tell them that you did not see me.
Why not stay here with
Mama,
us?
Mama, please.
No matter how you hate, do not hate an innocent. No matter how you feel,
this scarf is the only thing I was able to get out from her bag before she left for the palace.
Oh, she has gone to live in the palace already.
Not too long ago. But wait, are you sure the medicine man will be able to work with this scarf?
Yes, I believe. Let's just go and see him with the scarf to know if he's going to knock her down. Let's go.
Are you sure this is a good idea? I feel a type of way about this. Seriously. In as much as I really want to get my pound of flesh, she's still my sister, the same blood.
Yeah? You're not doing anything bad, Ife. You're just doing this to someone who has hurt you that way. Yeah? Let's go. Let's go and see you. There's no time.
Anamaka, anamaka, ajuju kamnaju. She is gifted.
Thank you for accepting to come stay with us here in the palace. I believe you will like it here.
I am really, I'm already enjoying myself. What can I say? It's quite spacious, very big.
Yeah. Wow. I'll show you all you need to know. My grandfather, great-grandfather, had this common room where he digs and receives all his special guests. I'll take you to the room.
Really? I can't wait. Nice. I can't wait to see this place you're talking about. I also wanted to ask you, is it possible for me to see anyone's future and tell them? I mean, in the palace, even if it's a guard?
Yes, my dear. Consider this place your new office where you can receive people and people can come and visit you. As for your parents, the palace will take care of them.
A message for that man.
Is there more?
Yes.
Why not? Let's go in so you can tell him.
But you know he doesn't like me.
It doesn't matter. Just go in there and deliver the message to him. Whatever he does with the message shouldn't be your business. Come on.
My king, I beg to leave. Her presence irritates me.
What has she done to me? Why is her presence irritating you, peasant?
It is better you listen to what I have to tell you. It's quite important.
Speak to me no more.
What is it, Azemo? Why won't you allow this young lady, this innocent, gifted young woman, to tell you the truth? What you must hear? What is your problem?
Go ahead, my dear. Let me hear you out.
Thank you, Your Highness. Please tell your son to stop hunting at the forest for now. There is this evil that is lurking around. Let him look for something else and do. I am telling you this because I know you love your son.
Zip it! Why are you blaspheming me? It is you that is going to be consumed by the spirit of death. Yes. My king, I beg to leave. I can't stand it anymore, receiving an insult from this nitwit.
Relax, young woman.
You have done double, my daughter. You do not tell a sane man to get the hands off the fire. It is not done. I am proud of you. I commend your boldness.
Thank you, my king.
Mama, I am not happy at all. I am not happy. Baba, I've told you the best thing to do right now is to kill that girl and do away with anything that has to do with her in this village. You know what baffles me? The king hushed me while she was talking. He made me look like nothing in his presence. Baba didn't allow me to kill her myself. Let me strangle her by myself. My son, if I said now kill her, it is too late. You know why? She lives in the palace. She has security. Papa, use your charm and strike her dead. I just want her dead. So are we just going to fold our hands and lose everything that you've worked so hard for so many years? Papa, can you imagine her telling me not to go to the forest? That blah blah blah, what he wanted because of... Who is she to give me such a command? Who is she? My son. I think I need to. Papa, you better do something, you know. You better do something. I don't want you to lose everything you've worked hard for.
Grace, believe me, I don't know she was pregnant for me. She did not even tell me anything all these years. I did not even believe I would meet her again in life.
But I told you everything that girl says come to pass. Did I not tell you, or you've forgotten? I told you.
I know you told me, but believe me, I didn't believe I would see this girl again in this life. I know I slept with her before I got married. Believe me, I can never cheat on you.
I don't even understand all these things you're saying. I don't understand one single thing you're saying. But all I know is that this marriage is over. It is over.
Bam, 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 bam. Forgive me, please. Don't do this to me, please.
You're apologizing to me. Mm-hmm. So what happens to the lady?
The lady took me to her uncle, and uncle said that I should come and claim the children if I get her daughter married.
That's exactly what I said. Rightly as the Seer girl said it. She said it, and it has come to pass. Have you forgotten? I can't continue with this marriage anymore. I am sorry.
Please, please, Grace. Please, Grace.
I'm sorry.
Please, Grace. Please don't do this to me.
Greetings, Sesemo.
Why you get came later?
I am fine. I wish all is well. This one is
here. All is well.
No.
I am here to appeal to you.
Okay.
But first of all, I want you to have this envelope.
What do I do with that?
Take it and look inside it.
What do I do with all this money inside there?
My 2 million naira is inside this. Take it.
What do I do with it? Now I'm not doing it now.
I want you to pull your daughter out of the palace. Both of you leave this village now.
Ezemo, you want me to leave the village with my daughter? This village? Is that what you're saying?
Do you want me to add more money here? Leave this village.
Why? What did she do?
Your daughter made the king to shut me out. The whole villagers, they have shut me out. I am no more relevant in this village. She is doing my job, and I do not like it. Leave this village now. Or?
Ogini.
Obulong.
Ekuzile here. If not for one thing, I'm going to make it here back. What is wrong with you? You cannot touch my daughter. Let me tell you in plain language. You dare not come close to my daughter or do anything against my daughter. She's doing the works of the gods. Where did she go wrong? They revealed to her. She says, she tell people the way is revealed to her. If the king has shot you, I simply mean that you're no longer relevant. So if you cannot walk alongside with my daughter, you take a step out.
Quiet! You bow out. Have you lost your senses? This conversation is over.
Oh, Sheba, you can't do anything. You can't do nothing. I'm not going to you. You're not God. You wear them more. If not for one thing, go against what you ever. What's your problem? You can't touch my daughter. If you're tired, you take a walk. Onya Allah. You're no longer relevant. You come and threaten me. If not. Oh.
You are really trying by the amount of people you get to attend to on a daily basis. Do you find joy in exhausting?
Not at all, my prince. As a matter of fact, I think the palace is quite the best place for what I do.
I'm glad you said that. Well, then we need to make out a timetable for you and the villagers to see so you can have enough time to rest.
Wow. Thank you for that suggestion. It really shows that you care.
Of course I care, Ujunwa, and I will always do, right from the very first day we met. You know, you have become an important part of my life now, which gladdens my soul that you are here with me now. I love you, Ujunwa.
Are you going to?
But you can see I'm fully equipped. I'm going for hunting.
In that forest? Didn't you hear what that girl said? This year, Papa.
Don't tell me you're beginning to believe what I need to say.
Why did I say this? What is going on?
Ejike.
Don't worry. Go to the forest.
Go for your hunt and come back with a big catch. Yes!
I shouldn't go because of that retreat. Papa, I'm going to hunt. And when I return, Papa, I'll do according to what I promise. I'll butcher that girl. I'll make sure I'll kill her.
That's right. That girl will die this time.
Yes, Papa.
I have given her mother a chance to halt her. But no, she believes in the forces behind the girl. This time around, I will tell the Nomuabu Omimin, the one of this kingdom.
Ofu.
Omimin, the one of this kingdom.
Yes, Papa.
Onye Memboto, I am Fachini Ike.
No time.
Yes! Ngamoke.
Eh, Daddy.
Welegu.
All right, sir. Papa.
Eh? Ejike, Ejike.
Eh, Papa.
Odogu Mwang.
Eh, Papa.
Anai Mule.
Oh, yeah, look off on
Like I'm saying, I think we have handled the problem.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Come on.
Come here. Looking so beautiful.
Thank you.
Are you okay? Why are you shouting? Are you okay? Look at me, look at me. What is it?
Huh?
What is it?
I can't see.
You can't see?
I can't.
Look, look, look.
Wait!
You mean you can't see me?
Oh!
Hold on. You mean you can't see me?
I can't see. I can't see. I can't see anything.
I can't see! I can't see.
Guards! Come
on! I can't see.
You can't see.
They brought news from the palace that your sister has gone blind. Has gone blind. Don't have to so.
Blind? How? When did this happen?
They just told me, and I know that it's Ezemo that did this. I know Ezemo is behind this.
Mama, you can't be too sure. No, you can't be too sure like that.
Hey,
you cannot be too sure considering how her mouth was. Maybe she must have gone to say one or two to somebody that provoked. You can't be too sure.
If you were, Ezemo was here yesterday to warn me against your sister. He warned me to talk to her. I can beat my full chest and tell you that Ezemo is behind this. And I must go to the king and tell him about it.
Mama, if you ask me, I would say going to the king to accuse Ezemo wrongly will bring serious enmity between you and Ezemo, between our household and him. Please, you don't have to do that. Firstly, you have to be calm.
Don't tell me that.
How are you even sure that she's blind?
Who else would have done that if it's not Ezemo?
Who confirmed that she's
but they
blind?
Told me, and they sent the message from the palace now,
that she's blind.
Yes.
How?
And I know that it's Ezemo. I know. I will tell the king, and the king will ask Ezemo to swear. If he doesn't swear, I will go around the village and announce it that Ezemo is a bad man. Ezemo is a...
Mama, calm down now. How can you accuse somebody like Ezemo to go and swear? That's a big one, you. Mama, stop crying first. Let's go inside. Let's go inside. You want me to join you and start crying too? Mama, stop now. You make me start crying with you now. Oh, stop. Let's go inside.
No matter how you hate, do not hate an innocent. No matter.
Thank you.
My king, I told you. I told you you wouldn't listen to me. She is fraud and fake. She is suffering from the first repercussion of her evil deeds.
Ezemo, what are you saying?
What I'm saying, my king, is that the gods that she serves, they are wicked. She connived with them to destroy our villagers. She connived with them to bring turmoil to the royal family. She connived with them to disorient this kingdom. My king, all the people she said that will die, she destroyed them spiritually. She is evil!
Ezemo, stop this, please. I don't like it. This is a strong accusation and I will not take it.
I'm innocent.
Have you asked why she went blind? More repercussions are coming to her.
Ezemo, are you telling me that you do not have a hand in what is happening to her?
My king, my hands are clean. The gods of our ancestors can bear me witness. Yes. My king, you might know so many things about me. Most certainly, not that I am an evil man. For sure, I was jealous about her, the way she gnawed our people towards her. But I want everybody to stay away from her because her methods are evil, weird. Yes, my hands are clean.
I am innocent. I am innocent, please. I have never thought any evil for any human. I don't know why someone that I trust would want to do this to me.
Do you know the person that did this to you? Do not hesitate to tell me because I'll have the person's head beheaded instantly. Talk to me, my daughter.
My king, she lies a lot. If you take her words, you will kill too many people in this kingdom. Yes, take for instance, she said, my son will die if my son will not give up his hunting method or his hunting tax. But today my son is in the bush, hunting. It was revealed to me by the gods of our ancestors that he is coming back with a big cash. Yes.
She's evil.
I am innocent.
This is my king. What is it?
I just got the news that Ezemo's son is dead.
What?
Ezemo's son is dead.
Are you out of your senses?
A report came to me that his son's corpse was found in the Okene forest, badly mutilated by a wild animal.
Oh, my king.
Oh. Don't touch him.
The evil that men do live with them.
Exactly, Father.
Thank God, though. I was coming to you, my darling. I was coming to you. Hi. Hey.
My sister, there is trouble. There is serious trouble. What are you talking about? I am sure you've heard about your sister's blindness. So she's going to be sent out of the palace disgracefully. My sister, the main problem is my mother. That woman will not allow me to rest. She's threatening to go to the palace to go and report her Ezemo to the king so that he will be made to swear his innocence about my sister's blindness. But it's not the Ezemo that did it now. Is it? Yes! That is where the problem is. By forcing him to swear his innocence, The man will be forced to want to find out the people behind it. Hi. That is where you and I come in.
Jesus.
Hey, Jesus.
Hey.
Timo.
What are we going to do about this?
Well, I am going to that that medicine man's place. I want him to undo whatever he has done to my sister. And please, Mbam, let her just come. I know she hurts me. Eh? I trust him. Mbam. I don't want it again. No, let her go in peace.
Ife, no, we can't undo anything, no, we can't.
Wait. Onyi, Chalokwao, are you by any means understanding what I'm saying?
Yes, now.
I said there is trouble, and I see me now, what I'm getting.
Let's not do anything, let's just leave it that way.
Odi can measure back to that SMO's place, I'm moving there. Yes, I'm going to that man's place now.
Onyi, are you going?
Hey,
are you coming with me? Eh? We should go together now. I know that this is the work of the enemy. Ezemuo is the one that did this to my daughter.
Ezemuo?
Yes, Your Highness.
Are you sure of what you're talking about?
Your Highness, Ezemuo came to me and offered me money. He offered me money to carry my daughter and go away from this village, else I'll face the consequences. He came to my house. To my house.
Are you sure of what you're talking
about? Your Highness.
Ezemuo did this?
Your Highness.
Ezemo will leave me with no other option but to strip him of all his rights in this kingdom. I will banish him. He is no more qualified to be the chief priest of this, my noble kingdom.
Your Highness, please, before you banish him, ask him to come and swear. Let him swear that he doesn't have a hand in what happened to my daughter. I don't know what my daughter did to Ezemo that he hates her this much. Let me know what he did. Please.
Father, I think you should invite Ezemo and have him swear to an oath of innocence.
Thank you, my prince, Chimgoziegio. Thank you.
Ezemo must be heartbroken by now after the loss of his only son. Yes.
If you want, okay, okay. Okay. What is this now?
I did it.
Forgive me. Forgive me, oh. Mama, eh? Tell her to forgive me, please.
You did what?
I am the one that made her black.
Hey!
I took anger because of the death of Obiora. I just wanted her to feel small pain. I need all that to get to this level. If you were making me, if you were, you did what? Yeah. If you were, you did what? You did what? You did what? You did what? You did what?
But why would you do that?
Yeah. I have never thought about any evil against you. I've never wished you any evil. Why would you want to do that to me, your sister?
Mama, Mama, I'm dying. I'm in pain. Hey, Mama, help me.
It's okay, it's okay.
If you want.
Would you?
I forgive you.
Thank you.
If you
want. Thank you. If you want, how should I keep? What did you? How did you do this?
I want to thank you for everything. I want to seize this opportunity to let you know of my intention towards Ujumwa here. I find it pleasing to present to you my newly found bride.
Yeah? My prince.
I know this came so sudden and unexpected, but there's no other better way for me to express myself. And there's no other time better than this moment. Ujumwa, please, be my wife.
My prince.
Yes.
Yes.
You'll marry me.
Yes, I will marry you. Hey, thank you, Your Highness.
Thank you so much.
Mama.
It's okay.
Come here.
Thank you.
It's okay. It's okay. Thank you.
Say happy family.
Oh, thank you, my prince. Your thank Highness. You.
Father, come, my daughter.
Hi. Thank you, Your Highness.
Thank you, Your Highness.
I bless this marriage.
No matter how you hate, do not hate an innocent. No matter how you feel, do not hurt an innocent. Makala. In the sage, oh, do not hurt an innocent. No matter the fury, no matter the rage, do not hate an innocent. To hate the innocent is to imprison the sage, oh, do not hate an innocent. She won't be careful, you may dig a pit, you will fall in.